is Leanne coming to you from the office of the Ascend team. I know this is going to be one of our most watched videos in the training center because there are a lot of questions, especially from new independent beauty consultants, specifically regarding home office deductions. What's deductible, what's not, how does it work, and all of those things. While we're not going to focus today specifically on what you can and cannot deduct, I'll let you talk to your CPA about that, I want to help you understand the heart behind how business deductions actually work so that you can then apply this directly to your business. So if you have a spouse or somebody who's helping you with your business and you want them to understand this, then this is a great video to bring them in on, especially if it's tax time and you're crunching to get your taxes done. So let's back up and first talk about what a business is. A business is a for-profit organization, or it is a for-profit venture. So the first thing you need to understand about taking business deductions is that you must run your business like a business if you want to take deductions. Right now, IRS has huge initiatives that are, where they're trying to actually reclassify many home-based businesses in order to generate tax revenue to kind of help pay for the financial crisis that we've had in our nation. And the reason that they're doing that is that they know that many home office owners or business owners that work from their home may not understand fully that they need to run their business intelligently and like a business, and so therefore they can be reclassified as a hobby. Hobbies cost you money, and by law you cannot write off your expenses for your hobbies, whether your hobby is scrapbooking or golfing or Mary Kay. So know first and foremost, before we talk about direct expenses and indirect deductions, that the first and foremost thing that you must always guard when it comes to wanting to take deductions and what is deductible versus what's not is you must run your business like a business. Here at the Training Center, we have tons of videos that help you know exactly what to do to make sure that your business is never classified a hobby. That being said, let's talk about direct expenses. Direct expenses are expenses that you incur as a business owner because you are in business. Whenever I'm teaching a new consultant or teaching a seasoned sales director this, I always want to communicate the thought that you would not have this expense were you not in business. So think of all the things that you have come to spend money on in your Mary Kay business because you're in business. So things like buying supplies for skincare classes. You wouldn't buy those supplies were you not running a Mary Kay business. Things like shipping product to your customers. You wouldn't incur that shipping charge if you were not in business. So direct expenses are fairly easy to understand because they are direct expenses of the business. And as long as you run your business like a business and not like a hobby, your direct expenses should be fully deductible on your IRS Schedule C. What's less understood and what's more confusing is indirect deductions. Indirect deductions are deductions that happen on the back end when you file your taxes. So the two main ones that you're going to find that are true for your business are going to be the home office deductions, as well as any deductions that you may take as far as driving your car, mileage deductions. The reason that this is confusing is because these are indirect deductions of your business. IRS and Congress began to recognize that the home-based business community was growing so fast, and as a result of that, they legitimized what you do in your Mary Kay business within your home by allowing you to write off a portion of the home that you use exclusively for business, as well as the miles that you drive on your car for business purposes. But those aren't direct expenses of your business. I think of them in terms of a perk. You're allowed to write them off. It's a benefit to you. It's one of the many benefits of having a Mary Kay business, is the ability to reduce your tax bill by writing off a portion of the things that you would already have in play. So let me help you understand it this way. If you were not in a Mary Kay business and you didn't have a home-based business, then you would still have a home. And within that home, whether it was a rental or a home that you own, you would pay for water, sewer, garbage, electricity, gas, etc., etc., not to mention a house payment. So regardless of whether you have a business or not, IRS says you need to have a place to live. So you can't write off 100% of where you live. But you can write off a portion of what of the home that you use exclusively for business purposes. So when your taxes get filed, so when your CPA sits down and actually files your tax return, it's at that point that you get the perk. It's at that point that this indirect expense becomes a reality in reducing your taxable income. The same is true for your mileage. So what I want you to understand is if you're a brand new independent beauty consultant, you do not need to sit down today and calculate what the square footage of your home is and what portion of your home you're going to use exclusively for business purposes, and then decide what percentage that is and divide it by 10 and put it into your budget, and that your business needs to pay the mortgage at that percentage. No. You are in business, and you get to write off a portion of your mortgage and all of your utilities for that place, but you don't need to put that percentage into your operations budget. I get asked that question all the time. So, quick recap. Direct expenses are expenses that you incur because you are in business. Now, if you have not watched the cost of goods sold video or the COGS video, I encourage you to find that here in the training center and watch it, because it will talk about inventory as a direct expense of your business and how that becomes a deductible item. Another thing here is with indirect expenses, don't budget those indirect expenses into your business overhead. Your accountant will deal with the indirect expenses when he or she files your taxes. And if I may say so, never try to save money by reducing your expenses in the area of hiring a CPA. That is not an area of your business that you want to cut. And as a small business owner that works from home, let me advise you that it is an unwise decision to use TurboTax or file your taxes by yourself, especially given the new IRS initiatives for home-based businesses. So pay for CPA. Good advice is worth paying for.